peanut butter.
15 minutes prior to you getting married, and you're in your flame pool. All right.
Yeah, I didn't even take 5 minutes ago. I was like, hey, what's that? Surreal now.
What's that?
Y'all
play. Y'all play game cards?
Yeah.
What?
The diesel fist?
Go ahead.
There.
Sorry. Good. This is a U.S. wedding.
Before God this afternoon, before your family and friends who are before you.
No.
According to God's holy ordinance, I keep, take you, Christine, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. And therein, I pledge you my trust. According to God's holy ordinance, I, Christine, take you, Keith, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. And thereto, I pledge you my trust. Husband and wife, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Would you please pray with me? Oh God, how good it is to be here today. To be involved in such an important part of the lives of Christine and Keith and their families. What a special day it is, and we sense your presence in our midst. We thank you for Christine and Keith. We thank you for their parents and grandparents and their families who've seen them through thick and thin, good times and bad times, and now are here today to say, Keith and Christine, we are for you and we will be for you for the rest of your lives. We thank you, Lord. We pray blessing upon Christine and Keith. Oh Lord, when the days come where there's so much joy, help them to celebrate your love for them. When the days come where there may be sadness, may they look to you, Lord, knowing that you're there for them and you will see them through. Again, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this celebration. And we pray, Lord, that this marriage relationship is to the honor and glory of God. For it's in Jesus' name that we pray. May the love of God be above you, Keith and Christine, to overshadow you, beneath you to uphold you, before you to guide you, behind you to protect you, close beside you and within you to make you able for all things, and to reward both your faithfulness with a joy and a peace that the world cannot give. Neither can it take it away. Amen. Kiss each other. Honor and privilege to present to you this afternoon Mr. and Mrs. Keith and Christine Kirk.
This will be Keith and Christine's ride once they come out of the aisle here. We'll get some more video of it here shortly. But these are a nice set of horses here. Set of horses. They're gonna ride on the carriage here. Here comes Keith and his new bride, Christine. Very good, Keith.
You should like go again.
Keep your applause going. Next we have Michelle Farley escorted by Joshua Smith. Next we have Myla Merkel escorted by Mr. Ben Gutwald. Catherine Librock escorted by Mr. Jeff Norton.
Come on, y'all, let's hear it.
And we got some important people that help pull this all together. We have the matron of honor, Emily Smith, escorted by Ethan Lucian. And we've got the maid of honor, Cassie Augustine, escorted by the best man, Barry Clare.
And now, for the cutest couples in the house, John, who do we got?
Oh, we've got flower girls and ring bearers. Bring in Everett and Laura Smith, Micah and Emery Sands.
Aren't they cute? If you're not standing, please stand up. But I know most of you are. But please, if you're not standing, please stand up.
Can I kneel?
You may kneel, but it's not that kind of day for you. Lady, can you kneel? Seriously? I just got that. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce, for the second time in public, Mr. and Mrs. Christine and Keith Kurtz! Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, your bride and your groom. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up, your bride and groom, the parents, the bridesmaids, the ushers, and don't forget the ring bearer and the flower girls. Alright, there'll be enough of that later, don't worry. Ladies and gentlemen, this time the bride and groom like to do their first dance as bride and groom. for the bride and her father, Griff and Christine. There you go, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it. We are popping bottles tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Don't stop till you get enough. Now these will be the toast for all of you. But I don't think the top one's gonna be yours, that might be theirs. We got more bottles, yeah. We got more bottles? Yes. Keep the party going. Now the tricky part is the ones in the middle. It's like Jenga with champagne glasses. This is great. There you go. One bottle done. It is really cool. Now here's the question. How are we going to take those off? Start at the top. So we grab the bottom one first, he says. Where do I want you? Right here? Right here? Actually, let's go over here next to your bridesmaids and groomsmen. Alright. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start off with the toast, starting with Emily. Ladies and gentlemen, give a big round of applause for Emily. Emily? Emily? I'm sorry. Don't we all? Don't we all?
I really do. But really, though, can I get a drink?
But seriously, can I get a drink?
Kevin's such a gentleman. His mother
did. Okay. Oh, Kevin.
Okay. I'm going to try to keep it short and sweet. Really, really nervous, so bear with me. Last night, my husband said something that I thought rang really true with most great couples, and I think with Keith and Christine too. And he said that to our son, he said, everything that he isn't, I am. I think we complement each other, and in the same way, we're like the same person in so many ways. So I think Keith and Christine are a lot like that, and that's why they work, and that's why they're going to work and make it. Last bit of advice comes from an unexpected or maybe, you know, weird place, but Dr. Phil always says, right. Dr. Phil says that you should wake up every day trying to make your partner's day better. And I think that's really true. And I try to think of that all the time. It doesn't always happen. And, rude. Doesn't always happen. It's really hard sometimes, but when it does happen, life is really good, and you'll make it. So, congratulations. Cheers, Mr. and Mrs. Kurtz.
Ladies and gentlemen, good up for the Matron of Honor, Emily. Now,
and chill, Christine. But it was a good thing, because you could just see Keith. You could see his happiness, and I think that we all saw that in friendship, and we encouraged him towards her. Not the fact that he thought that she wasn't the one or anything along those lines, but she just made him better. And that was just something that we saw, and happy. And you know, in that, it's authenticity. And you know authenticity in a relationship when it's ecstatic, and that's what they are, and I congratulate you guys for that.
Cheers. Ladies and gentlemen, give it a round. Thus far, it's been an excellent, fantastic celebration. I've known Keith for around 15 years. We met on the lacrosse field in junior high.
Yeah.
And something about lacrosse, there are four main positions. Three of them are basically interchangeable, but there is one position on the field that one guy plays that everybody counts on. That's goalie. And that was Keith here. Keith literally put his body in between the field and the goal to protect the goal from the other team when everybody else was too tired to play and to be effective. You know, and if you've ever held a lacrosse ball, you understand that 5 ounce solid ball of rubber is not something you want to get hit with, especially at 50 to 60 miles an hour, which is what Keith did, and that's what he did to help his team be reliable. And that takes a lot of strength and courage, and that's something that Keith continues to do every day. Something that we relied on him to do every single day at lacrosse was get our backs, and he's been an excellent friend doing that to all of us ever since, and I don't think there's a friend here of his who would deny that. I don't think there is a woman in the world more perfect for Keith. Christine, you are so unbelievably smart, beautiful, funny, and did I say smart? I'll say intelligent. But I wish the best for you. And cheers.
Cheers. Ladies and gentlemen, the best man, Barry. And last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, give it up, the maid of honor.
I just want to start off by thanking each and every one of you for coming out tonight. It's been a great day. I'm gonna try not to cry. So, I have known Christine for 21 years now, and she's been my best friend for 18 years. And instead of telling you guys all these funny stories about us, because it might bore you guys, Christine might like it, but I don't know if anybody else would. I prepared a little poem for the couple up here. I'm not a poet, so bear with me. Christine, my all-time favorite friend, you'll be in my life until the end. We started as second grade classmates, but soon became sister soulmates. Leaving our houses to meet halfway, we were secret agents and runaways. Dreaming of the day we would hold bouquets. College came and we had to part, but for a good reason, for us to get smart. Next chapter starts off when Cupid's arrow struck. We were having girl time at the Lucky Duck. Little did Christine and Keith know, from that moment on, their love would grow. It began with trial dog dates. That turned into real dinner dates and grew into forever soulmates. Now looking at the two of you, I see a love that is kind and true, one that will always make it through. There's no more champagne. But now if you would all raise your glass for a toast, Christine and Keith, may your troubles be less and your blessings be more, and may nothing but happiness come through your door. Cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the unknown poet, the maid of honor, Cassie.